Hey guys, it's Pierre, the Fish Beast. I wanted to show you a video, kind of a video overview of the stand that came with my 210-gallon Aquion aquarium. So, this thing is supposedly made from pine wood, which is, I guess, a pretty decent wood. It's not made of MDF or particle board. But I wanted to show you real quick, and I want to thank Shane for taking this video, the features of the stand, and also the problems I have with it. So this is a stand that has three doors, and there's a plywood, a very thin plywood bottom that's flush with the floor. It's got an open top, which is all you really need if your aquarium is glass. With a glass aquarium, you just really need supports on the edges, okay? There's space for a sump, which is a type of filtration system that involves putting another container of water, usually an aquarium, underneath, and then having the water from that go up to your main aquarium and then overflow back down. The problem I have with this stand is that I think it's poorly constructed. As you can see, although they did use real wood, there's a lot of fitment and measurement gaps. I want to show you where the wood has split here already. You can see right there, there's a little split in the wood. This thing also isn't really screwed together, okay? They use staples. They use staples to attach the uprights to the horizontals, okay? This is a staple right there, and that's what's holding up your tank. I don't know about that. The biggest problem I have with this thing is that when I got it, there was a major defect, and I had to send it back to where I bought it from, and props to Dominic at the Aquarium Paradise in Lakewood. They made it right. Unfortunately, the new stand that they took great pains to deliver to me, again, has some problems. The biggest and most glaring one was this upright. It had actually come out and off of the wood, so I've had to reinforce it with some screws and pull the staples out. I also want to show you just how uneven these upright boards are. You see, they're not flush with each other. This one's bowed out a little bit. So, I don't like it. Look at this huge gap. Look at this huge gap right there. It's a major gap in the corner, which is bad. Okay? So I'm calling out Aquion, aka All Glass Aquariums. I know your beam counters and your engineers have designed this to make it as fail-safe as possible to minimize lawsuits and warranty claims. So I guess it is the bare minimum of a stand that can hold up an aquarium of this size. However, come on. For 300 bucks, you can do better. This is a ripoff, okay? So what I'm gonna need to do at the very least, if I don't build a new stand altogether, which I'm not really big fan of doing at this point, I'm gonna have to reinforce these uprights with some wood that I'll have to cut to measure. I want to show you also how light this stand is, okay? I'm not a strong dude, okay, but I can lift this thing pretty easily with one hand, one side of it anyway. And I want to show you something also pretty concerning. Despite the cross bracing, it has a little bit of flex. See, look at this. There's some flex. I don't like flex, okay? I don't like flex supporting a 2,300-pound object that's sitting on one of my hardwood floors. So we're gonna have to do some work with this thing, or I might have to build a new stand altogether. Okay, I'll check in with you later. Thanks for watching.